The Russians have finally taken action after dealing with years of political turmoil in Tajikistan. Over 200 tanks with support troops have moved in to quell the uprising. While refugees by the thousands flood Red Cross shelters in neighboring Uzbekistan, the Kremlin claims to be taking a short-term police action. But reports from Tajikistan indicate the locals are preparing for the grim specter of a long-term Soviet occupation.
The Gateway Space Station, our stepping stone to the stars, a conduit for future missions to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. What you're looking at here is two-thirds of the station. Gateway's lower and mid-station are semi-operational. They're connected by this elevator. The upper station should be finished by year's end. Once the station is complete, the centrifugal force of orbit will create micron gravity. On the upper and lower station, gravity essential for research in space. The mid station has what we call magnetized gravity. Micro-thin strips of steel are placed in the astronauts' mission suits and equipment. We magnetize the floors, and voila, gravity. Now, if you all come with me, I'd like to introduce you to the crew for our first international mission to the station. Ladies and gentlemen, our crew led by Captain Previ Fedorov of the Russian Republic. If you have any questions, please.
Yes. Captain, you've been on so many missions. Has it become at all routine?
Routine? No, never.
How does it feel to be the first non-Americans to command a shuttle mission?
It is both an honor and a privilege, especially for a young man from Moscow who was not very good at math.
Is it difficult being the only American member of this flight crew?
No, we've trained many months for this. We don't anticipate any problems.
Do you like America, Captain?
I've been here before. I studied at the University of Pennsylvania for 3 years, so it's not exactly my first taste of America.
How does it taste?
I like your apple pie. Your football confuses me. Nobody uses their feet.
In the back?
Captain, you were born in Tajikistan. How do you feel about Russia's intervention?
My country's history is a history of sorrows. We have never enjoyed the freedoms that you enjoy in the West. Now it looks as though we never will.
So you're against Russia's intervention?
As a boy growing up, I had a dream to fly in space. Russia gave me that dream. I will not judge her. But any time people cannot solve their differences, when they must use guns to find peace, when they are willing to let their country become subject to another nation, that is tragedy. My prayers go out to the young men of Russia and Tajikistan, to the boys that will suffer and die for the misunderstandings of old men.
That's all the time we have.
One more question, please.
All right, JJ. Let's rev her up and bring her down nice. No bumps or bruises this time, okay?
Roger that. Re-entry computer on. Trajectory engaged. Burning aft thrusters.
Give me a 12-second burn at 70%.
Bring the nose around.
That's it. Almost there. Okay, JJ. Get ready to surf the skies. Uh-oh.
What? Uh-oh. What's wrong?
Just a little company. Nothing to worry about.
Keep your eyes on the fancy buttons, the flashing lights. I'll do the rest, okay?
Switching to manual.
Once the X-33 is operational, it'll be able to take off and land from any major runway in the world. Its gas and go prep time means that it could launch in a matter of hours at 10% of a shuttle budget.
All right, bringing the nose around to minus 45 degrees.
So this thing can take off from Tokyo or Los Angeles?
It would make a little more noise than I think people could tolerate, but yes, it could happen.
You're getting a worm, JJ, but you're fine. Let's get it right this time. We've got a crowd out here.
How soon will this be ready?
2 years, maybe less. We
What you're looking at is a test of the re-entry procedure.
I'm getting hotter, Pritch. I'm gonna ease her up a little bit.
No can do. Hold her at 15 degrees. You're fine.
So this will fly right into space?
That's right. Right into Gateway's lower station, where it exchanges passengers and then returns to its runway of choice.
This re-entry and landing procedure, it's a fairly basic maneuver.
I'm putting her in a 12-degree angle. See if I can slip her in with a little less resistance.
15 degrees, JJ. Anything less and you'll bounce right out of the atmosphere.
It's too hot. I'm burning up in here.
Hang on, JJ. A few more seconds, you've got it.
A few more seconds and I'll blow the hydrogen tank. I gotta pull up.
Those tanks will take 2,500 plus. You're fine. Just keep her coming.
This is what you call a smooth transition. I'd like to see a bumpy ride.
Our pilots are the best in the world. Sometimes it gets a little hot in there.
I gotta pull her up 12 degrees!
3 more seconds. Hold on, JJ. You can do it.
The bottom's melting. I gotta pull up!
Hang on, JJ.
I'm pulling up!
Catastrophic system failure.
Damn it. JJ, wait.
Please, follow me.
JJ, why'd you pull out?
The X-33 is nothing more than a fuel sack with a pilot. Every engineering spec I've read said hydrogen blows at 2,500 degrees. I'm not dying in that thing.
Okay, well, pulling up like that just bounced you all the way to Venus.
The computer bounced, not me.
What?
You heard what I said. The simulator's wrong. I know how to make an approach. 12 degrees will be just fine.
It's 15 degrees. Face it, JJ. You bounced out.
Well, what are you saying? That was pilot error?
No, it's pilot arrogance. The simulator's right. 99.9% of the time, I can't say your odds are the same.
Then find a better pilot.
I don't want a better pilot. I want a better you.
You don't like this year's model? Don't buy it!
Why is it you always put me in front of the press junkets?
Because you're the most photogenic engineer I've got.
You mean the only one with breasts?
I hadn't noticed. How'd it go?
Great, until Hendrix bounced the X-33.
Again?
What's he doing flying sims? This doesn't have anything to do with his accident, does it?
He made a mess for us, Amanda.
So you grounded him?
Not that hard. We scratched him from commanding the launch and offered to send him up as Federoff's co-pilot.
And?
He refused. How's work going on the remote link? Fixed?
I can't tell yet. Nevsky says everything's A-OK, but the diagnostics are coming out wrong.
He hasn't found the bug.
Nope.
You think you could?
Pete, it's a hardware problem. I'd have to check every component on the station.
Then why don't we do that?
You can't just bring the computer down. Taking it apart would take months.
I have no intention of bringing it down. I'm sending you up, unless, of course, you have a better idea.
Well, what about the tech team? Why don't you send them up?
I don't know that they can fix it. I do know that you can, which is why I'm sending you.
Pete, I am not prepared. I am a computer systems specialist. I am not an astronaut.
Atlantis doesn't leave for 2 weeks. That's enough time to bring you up to speed on the basics.
Now, what about Ethan? I can't just leave him alone.
Ethan can stay at my house. I'm sure Sarah won't mind watching him for a couple of days.
It's one thing to have bad luck. It's another thing to go out and make it.
The sim's wrong. I can take it in at 12 degrees.
Then work with me on it, not against me. Besides, you could use a few friends around here. Why don't you take a mission as co-pilot? Go up and show them they can trust you.
Whoa. What's your title these days, Pritch? Chief Engineer of Advanced Aerospace Technologies, correct? Okay. So what would you do if they asked you to test fuel mixtures?
They wouldn't. They've got lab guys to do that kind of thing.
I realize that. But if they did?
I quit.
Bingo. I'm a flight commander with 3 missions under his belt. I'm nobody's co-pilot.
What about the X-33? You're the only guy trained to fly. As soon as it's ready...
What about the X-33? That thing's not gonna be ready for flight for 2 years. By the time they get it up there, I'll be teaching rookies how to fly it. You know it and I know it. Let's face it. I don't get this next mission, I'll be testing sims the rest of my career.
Interesting piece of flying you pulled off this morning, Captain Hendricks. The simulator's busted.
Or so you say. I'd like to give it a try, if you don't mind. I think I saw the cause of the problem.
What, you think you could do it better?
Maybe, who knows?
Maybe. Well, that's optimistic.
I heard a lot about you, Captain. Where I come from, we have a saying. If you can't control your wings, don't reach for the sky.
I'll reach for anything I want, thanks.
Or crash into it.
Captain? If you don't mind me saying, I expect more from a man who's about to lead me into space.
My apologies, Miss McCord. If you'll excuse me.
Lead you into space? You're going up?
That's right. I can't say I'm excited about it, but yes, I'm going.
Amazing.
You know, Captain, if you didn't have such a chip on your shoulder, maybe you wouldn't have such a crack in your record. You're a great pilot. Why don't you start believing in yourself and prove it?
Oh, see, French. I'm making new friends already.
What are you doing up?
Are you really going into space?
You bet.
But you don't want to go.
No, I want to go. I just want to bring you with me, but I can't.
Can I go when I'm bigger?
When you're big enough, you'll be able to go anytime you want.
Really?
Really. Now, come on. I want you to go to sleep. Good night.
Good night.
I'll see you in the morning. I'll call you when I get to the cake, okay?
Can you take this with you?
Of course I can, honey.
It'll bring you good luck.
Ah, thanks. Thanks, Sarah and Pete. I really appreciate this. Just remember, no soda after 8 o'clock.
Got it. 8 o'clock.
Okay. I love you, honey. Be a good boy.
Good luck, Amanda.
Thanks.
What happened the other day will not create a problem for us.
It's already forgotten.
I'd like to apologize.
Apology accepted. Not necessary, but accepted.
Friends?
Friends.
Or how we say in Russian, друзья.
This is a stabilization bed.
You will receive medical attention if you suffer from space sickness.
Right, check in 1 minute.
How long do you stay in?
Depends on your stomach.
And we always step in.
Okay.
And this vacuum, we always turn on the 2 minutes before. Huh? And here, well, you figure out for yourself.
Where do we flush?
Flush it over here like that. And then this is for the privacy. Like that. Yeah?
Thank you.
You're fine, JJ. We're at a 15-degree pitch. We're almost there.
It's too hot!
Trust me on this one, she won't burn up. One more minute.
Catastrophic system failure.
Damn it!
You almost had it, JJ.
I can't believe I burned it up again.
Let's keep trying, come on.
Hey, Pritch, in case you didn't notice, if that thing had been real in there, I'd be dead right now. That's it, I'm through.
The Atlantis takes off tomorrow. It could have been you, JJ. Could have been you.
Miss McCord,
Is this your boy?
Oh, I forgot it, yes. His name's Ethan.
I found the tape to your locker. Would you like me to put it in your mission case?
Thank you, I'd like that.
He's got your eyes, like a fox.
A fox?
Quick, insightful, always on guard. He'll be a smart boy, I'm sure he gets that from you.
Well, the less he's like his father, the better.
You're divorced?
5 years and counting.
I'm sorry.
Oh, don't be. I'm not.
Can I tell you a secret? When they strap you in for lunch, think of your boy. Of him playing with his favorite toy. I have 4 boys of my own in Tajikistan. Think of them every time I leave the earth. Helps take the fear away.
Thank you.
Residents were shocked this morning when a T-38 jet crashed into their quiet neighborhood. Captain Jim Hendricks ejected from his jet when its engine failed. But how Captain Hendricks' jet ended up here, almost 300 miles off course, no one knows. But how Captain Hendricks' jet ended up here, almost 300 miles off course? Almost 300 miles off course?
Countdown continues for the venerable shuttle Atlantis. Liftoff is on schedule for 6:30 a.m. Eastern Time. This turned out to be quite a mission with its half-Russian crew and the last-minute addition of Amanda McCord, a NASA computer specialist who's being sent up to Gateway to track down some persistent computer problems. The shuttle crew should be arriving at the launch platform now.
SRP check.
Now we see the pilot getting into his seat. T-minus 5 minutes, and the external tank is being pressurized for flight.
This is Atlantis. All systems go.
T-minus 1 minute to launch, Canaveral. This is Houston. It's your show.
Entry into and out of the vehicle.
Tail sights.
Roger, Atlantis, you're go for a throttle up.
Main engine firing.
Atlantis, you are go for SRB separation.
SRB separation, T-minus 10.
Miko.
Main engine cutoff complete.
ET separation in T-minus 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
External tank separated.
External tank clear. Recovery team en route.
External tank tracking confirmed.
Take a look.
Atlantis, you can proceed with OHM burn.
After rockets firing, we have established orbit, switching to manual.
Sleep late?
I want to command the next mission to Gateway.
You and everybody else in the program.
You owe me, Pete.
I don't owe you anything, JJ. We offered to send you up.
I want to command a mission.
Then I think you should, but I'm not going to give you one. Not unless you tell me why you...
Not this again. It was my jet.
Yours to fly, not to crash. Why were you so far off your flight plan? You cooperate or you don't get a mission.
So that's it, then?
That's it.
My request to be discharged.
Is this what you want? Doesn't have to be like this.
I think it does.
You ever see it before?
I just never thought I'd see it this close.
Gateway, this is Atlantis. All clear for docking.
How's the trip, Captain?
By the numbers. Prepare to initiate docking procedure.
Docking procedure initiated. I'll guide you from here. That's a lock, Atlantis. Amanda, I never thought I'd see the day.
Captain, it's good to see you again.
It's good to see you, too. Captain Fedorov, George Tanner. Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Thank you for having us, Captain.
Oh, please. It's all my pleasure. After 4 months, any new face through that portal is welcome. Listen, after you folks get changed and get out of your suits, how about I give you a grand tour of the facility?
That would be nice, thank you.
I'd like to get some sleep if you don't mind.
Well, not at all. Why don't you get 40 winks and we'll reconvene in 2 hours? Michaels will show to your quarters, and Mafia, you show these gentlemen to their quarters. And you, young lady, get the tragic misfortune of having me be your escort.
Be my pleasure.
This one go to the research lab, huh? No. This is mine. I'll take later. The big one goes to the cargo bay. And the black one take to the library.
Thank you.
How about that remote link?
I got Nevsky working on it all day, every day, 24/7. He can't do anything without checking in with me.
That system shouldn't be malfunctioning.
Well, I'm sure whatever's wrong with it, you'll have it up and running good as new. Now, why don't we have some lunch? I have got a bottle of vintage apple juice.
No, thanks. I really want to take a look at the remote.
Amanda, you just got here.
I know, but I won't be able to think about anything else until I get a good look at it. Now, where can I find Nevsky?
Well, he's got to be around somewhere. There aren't that many places to hide. Why don't we start with the remote link?
Okay.
Come on.
Doesn't like me either. Ivan Nevsky. I'm glad to finally meet you, Amanda. And I'm sorry you had to come all the way up here.
It's bound to happen sooner or later.
No, you won't find anything. I've checked the codes and the hardware 100 times and still nothing. Nothing wrong. And nothing works.
Very strange. Are you the only one that's worked on it?
As far as I know, yes.
Well, I don't see anything wrong with it right now. I'll start in again in the morning. Good night, sir.
Good night.
What?
Amanda, she's been in the remote link.
You said you could hide it.
Yes, for most people, yes, but not her. She designed it. She knows. I know she does.
We'll move up to schedule.
Amanda, what the hell are you talking about?
Someone sabotaged the remote link.
No. No, it's not possible.
What do you know about Nevsky?
Nevsky was a weapons specialist for the Soviets. What do you mean, huh? You don't think that... Hold on. We got a message coming in from Houston. You're gonna want to look right over here.
Hi, Mom.
Ethan, honey, what are you doing up so late?
Uncle Pete said I could call and say goodnight.
I hope you don't mind him staying up this late.
How was the shuttle ride?
Bumpy.
Did you get sick?
No, honey. Mommy didn't get sick.
the cameras off?
They're looping.
Then it's time. All the way, comrades. All the way or nothing.
Hello, Captain.
Now you go to bed. It's past your bedtime.
Good night, Mom.
Good night. Mwah.
We'll talk tomorrow. Houston out. I think it's time we get this young man home to bed.
I don't get it. What do you think he's up to?
She said he sabotaged the motherboard. She was right. He did. Stay away from the console. Come with me now.
Where's Lieutenant Franklin?
Dead.
Dead? Are you out of your mind?
Very odd, Ashley. Move.
Pete, we've got an anomaly on Gateway.
What kind of anomaly?
The video feed. In the last 20 minutes, Lieutenant Franklin walked down that corridor twice. See? There he is again. That's the third time.
Anomaly my ass, a man can't sleep.
That's what I thought. But there's no way to get from one end of the hall to the other. The feed's looping on us.
Get Amanda back on the line.
I'm not getting an answer.
We just talked to her, for Christ's sake.
I've tried.
The havens will be more than enough oxygen.
What happened to friends?
You're still alive, aren't you?
How much here do we have?
We got enough. Enough for now.
Activate the satellites.
All right. Satellites are activated. I'm coming online.
There.
AD at your disposal. Initiating code encryption.
Get Houston on the comm link.
Anything?
Not yet. We've tried every channel. Digital, analog, even shortwave stuff. Nothing.
Now what?
Beats me.
Exactly 10 minutes ago, the Nevlet space defense system was activated. The Russian Third Army Group has exactly 12 hours to withdraw its forces from the People's Republic of Tajikistan.
What the hell is this?
If they do not withdraw, I will launch these satellites. If you try to intercept or jam the signal, I will launch the satellites. This is Captain Previ Fedorov. The Gateway station is in my control. If you try to compromise the station, I promise you, I will launch all the satellites.
Fedorov.
Jesus Christ. Who? How do I...
We should call NORAD.
Anybody have a phone number to NORAD? Christ, people, get me a government phone book and get the number to NORAD.
Yvonne, now it's up to them.
Pete, seems like we have a little problem.
That we do, sir. Follow me.
For 20 years, the best spies in the CIA assured me that the Nebulous system was a fake, a phantom weapon. Now, all of a sudden, the Russian ambassador tells me it's for real.
Can the Russians deactivate it?
No, none of the old access codes work. Russians say the only person to turn them off is up there on Gateway.
Nevsky.
Yeah, he designed the system. Turns out that he, Fedorov, and Badovsky were all born in Tajikistan. And the Russians, they are considering their options. So the question of the hour is, how soon can we get a shuttle up there?
34 days. What about NORAD? Can we knock him out of the sky?
Too many satellites would never have a chance of hitting all of them. I'd target that station, but it's beyond the legitimate range of anything we've got. Now, from what we have received from Russian intelligence and what our own people at the Pentagon have figured is that Fedorov has hooked up all of these satellites to an encrypted code system. Defense intelligence has the best programmers working on it, but they say it would take them at least a week to break it, if at all. So, assuming we cannot break the code, and assuming Fedorov really does have control of all those satellites, what are my options? How do I get my people up there?
The X-33.
Your report said it would not be operational for years.
We have a prototype ready.
How many men can it take?
Three, with a pilot.
Who do you plan on sending up there, General?
I'll have a team of Rangers here within the hour.
Rangers?
U.S. Army Special Forces. Believe it or not, gentlemen, we have trained for this.
There's a problem, General. The only pilot trained to fly the X-33 handed in his resignation yesterday.
You've still got this letter? Tear it up. I want him here now.
Sir, you need to come with us.
All right, come on in. I gotta change.
For freedom. Just for both.
The word if again. If the Russians don't pull their tanks back, and if Fedorov is for real, you're gonna have to go up there and deliver my Rangers right off Gateway. Do you understand that?
We still haven't figured out a way to bring the X-33 back down.
Pete?
The Rangers will board at mid-station. As soon as they secured the comm center, you dock at the lower station, take the elevator up, you all come home in the Atlantis.
Why not just dock the X-33?
The shuttle's in the docking bay. Even if it weren't, Fedorov would see you coming. This is our only shot. You make it. You got any command you want.
And if I don't?
I never said there wasn't any risk involved.
Pete, we're tracking one of the Nebulous satellites.
Where's it headed?
Right on top of us.
How long till impact?
It up just outside the atmosphere.
Any fallout?
No, it's too deep in the space to cause any damage, but you knew exactly where to detonate it.
Those Russian bastards better pull back.
Wait a second. We've got an incoming signal.
By now you've seen the power of the Nebulous system. Consider that a warning shot. The next satellite detonates 10 miles over a major U.S. city. The fallout will decimate the population.
All right, Fedorov. What's going on? Why us? Those are not our tanks attacking your country. It's not our war.
It is now. If Russia won't listen to me, they may listen to you. After all, you are the only world superpower. You've got 8 hours to convince Russia to withdraw. If they don't, I launch the next satellite. 8 hours, and I want proof.
How soon can I leave?
Can I help you?
I certainly hope so. Captain Hendricks, I'm your pilot.
Lieutenant Sittens, U.S. Rangers.
Wow. What the hell is that thing?
It's a recoilless rifle. Zero displacement for zero gravity engagements. Uses compressed lead powder shells. Hit something solid, and it breaks up on impact. Hit something that breathes, and that baby will rip through it like a hot knife.
Huh. Well, it's nice to know you're prepared.
Prepared my ass. When I signed up for this unit, I thought it was going to be the biggest damn vacation in the Army. Then some lieutenant calls me and says, congratulations. Tells me I got a mission. Go figure.
All right, well, as soon as you're done, step right through that doorway and we'll get suited up. I'll show you what we wear in my world.
You heard him.
I'll go check on the shuttle.
I'll go with him.
Gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. Once in orbit, we regret to inform you that there will be no refreshments and no in-flight movie. Enjoy the flight, and thank you for flying NASA.
Systems check complete. You are A-OK to go.
Captain, this is the tower. You're clear for takeoff.
OK, boys. Hold on. It might get a little bumpy.
You told me there was no way you could get that thing to work.
Not the way it's supposed to. Nevsky shut down Houston's ability to control the station from Earth. Now, if I can access the mainframe, we can control the station from here.
Okay, now what do you need to do it?
Blueprints. I need the blueprints. There's a comm link to every module of the station. I just don't know where to look. Now, if we could get a hold of NASA... Somehow, I don't think Fedorov is going to give us any free calls home.
Yeah, he doesn't have to. We can build a phone and call NASA from here. If we start with the intercom system...
What, are you crazy?
No, he's right.
There must be 100 digital satellites floating around out here.
Exactly. We could mirror one of the signals, and this could work.
Yes, but we need an antenna. Here, there's a mile of copper wire in here.
Come on, rip it out. I want you to build us a phone. I want you two to rig us an antenna. You and I have to find a power source to tap into. You start there, I'll start over here.
Got it.
We should be in striking distance soon.
Wow. She really is beautiful. Takes your breath away. Check your seals. I'll be depressurizing the cabin. Depressurizing on my mark. 3, 2, 1.
All right, man. Get ready to move out.
Give them hell, Rangers.
luck, guys.
This is Eagle One. Commencing tether launch.
Roger, Eagle.
There. Look. Some sort of ship. It's only 100 yards from the station.
Out. There is nothing that could have made it up here. The X-33 pilot. Hendrix finally made it off the ground. Follow me.
Magazine.
Real bullets.
Lead bullets will not penetrate the EVA suits.
Keep moving, Frazier. 50 yards to go. Murphy, stay in sync.
This is Houston. Do you read? Eagle One, come in. Eagle One. Eagle One, come in.
You're dead. They're all dead.
I was very clear on one point. Do not try to compromise this station.
You have 3 hours to convince the Russians, then I launch your satellite.
Listen to me, Captain. We are negotiating with the Russians, but we cannot just tell them what to do. They won't listen to that. Be patient.
Then try harder.
I have to inform the President.
I can see their bodies from here. They're just floating out there. Think they'll ever make it back to Earth?
Eventually. Listen, JJ. We think we found a new approach angle for the X-33. There's a good chance we'll make it down fine, right?
Down to what? I don't know, Pritch. I think I'd rather stay up here and take my chances.
After all, seems a shame to come all the way up here for nothing.
Yes, Mr. President. Yes, sir. It's in the hands of the Russians right now. All we can do is...
He's going to do it.
1 second, sir. He's going to do what?
Hendrix. He's going into the mid-station.
Mr. President, we have a new development. Yeah. Let me get briefed, and I'll get back to you. Thank you, sir.
Do you see it?
Yes, I see it.
Left the dock manually. There's no one on board to bring you in, JJ.
Yeah.
You want to come in straight.
So bring it around to 86 degrees Earth relative.
Spacewalk to the hatch, JJ. Be careful. We're gonna patch your headset with the X-33 so you can talk to us when you need to on a secure channel, you hear me? Call us when you get inside. Oh, one more thing, JJ. The lower station's still at zero gravity, so be careful moving around.
Lower station secured. Now what, Houston?
You'll have to make a tether run.
Why not take the elevator?
Take the elevator and he'll know you're there.
A tether run, huh? This doesn't sound like a joyride.
Come on, JJ, it's only 80 miles.
Only? All right, where do I start?
Okay, you need an emergency harness. It should be there, next to a portable thruster.
I got it.
You know, Pete, his only hope right now is Hendrix.
He's our only hope.
Okay, Pritch. How do I slow this thing down?
Two thruster burns. One every minute for the last 10 minutes. That should do it.
What if it doesn't?
Hit the mid-station 500 miles an hour, you wouldn't feel a thing.
That's a refreshing thought.
It's your decision.
How do you feel about JJ?
Look, if you're waiting for me to make a speech about how proud I am, don't hold your breath. Rich.
I'm right here.
Listen, the thing you said before about a better me, you were right. I'm sorry.
That's okay, buddy. Call me when you get to Gateway.
Now initiate 3-second thruster burn.
You got it. Houston, initiating thruster burn. I'll see you guys in 80 miles. I hope.
He's ready. All right, let's give it a shot. Houston, this is Gateway. Do you read me?
Houston, this is Gateway. Do you read me?
Think the Russians will pull out?
Oh, who knows? One thing about the Russians, they'd rather starve or freeze than give up. Ask Hitler.
Pete, General, we've got an incoming call. It's Tanner.
Tanner? What's going on up there?
You guys all right?
Yeah, Fedorov's got us locked up in cargo module number 3, and he's regulating the oxygen, but other than that, we're doing pretty good. Listen, Pete, Amanda thinks she can access the remote link, but she's gonna need a little help from you boys down there, so I'm gonna put her on, okay?
All right, go ahead.
Amanda, Fedorov's got the access codes encrypted up the Yazoo. Truth is,
I don't know the remote link is going to do you any good.
Listen, if I can connect to the remote link, I can get into the main computer, I can secure his access codes and disable them.
You sure?
Positive. I just need to get into the remote link from here.
Pritch, get on it. Find a way. How are you holding up, Amanda?
Okay, sir.
Listen, we have a man on his way up there now. It's going to take him a while to get there, but when he does, well, we'll just have to wait and see. Well,
okay, listen, how's Ethan? Does he know?
I haven't said anything to him yet. Do you want me to?
He's a smart kid. Just tell him the truth. Gateway out.
Previ. You better come.
They just started coming in.
Suddenly halted operations and are now in a full-scale retreat out of Tajikistan. The Kremlin had no comment on the mysterious withdrawal except to say they believe they have the situation.
Well done, Mr. President. Is your shuttle ready?
Yes.
Get on the intercom. Let the hostages know they'll be leaving.
Right.
But, how can we be sure they won't cross back?
If they cross back, we can still launch the system from the Earth.
The connection is gone.
Thank God I never have to live on this damn thing. We'll let them know when it's time.
Yeah, daughter.
Okay, that should do it. Let's see what we got here. Okay, I think I'm in. Just need to find the remote codes.
She's doing it. I knew she would.
Doing what?
Commander, she's trying to find the access codes to the remote link.
Is it possible?
No! I don't know. She designed it. Maybe there's something I don't know.
Come with me.
Okay, phone. Pete, I'm patched into the main computer. They're encrypted, all right. Look, I'm gonna have to send duplicate files down. It's gonna take a minute.
Amanda, if this works, Fedorov's gonna do everything he can to use you as leverage. It's gonna get ugly.
I'll worry about that later. Pete, I can't.
What did you tell him?
I wanted to talk to my son.
You're lying. You're trying to find out the codes. Do you think I want to go through with this, do you? My family, my brothers and sisters have known nothing but war for a decade, now occupation. I can change this. You have a child. Wouldn't you do the same?
How many people will you kill for one life?
If that child was my son, my niece or my nephew, I will kill as many as I have to.
Amanda!
Transmission's dead.
What is that noise?
Surveillance satellites, they're 80 kilometers from the border. Just sitting there.
What is this, Previ?
Gentlemen, I have just received word that the Russian withdrawal has stopped.
This is not good news.
What? We're talking to them now, Previ. You've got to give us some time.
Fedorov, they've run out of petrol. The damn Russians ran out of fuel. Did you hear that, Previ?
They're out of gas.
Do something.
Idiots.
Then get them some more. I'll give you 1 hour. 1 hour, and then one of your cities will burn, I promise you!
Where the hell is Hendrix?
JJ, where are you? We should have heard something.
Houston, this is Hendrix. Approaching gateway.
JJ, you should have hit your thrusters by now. You're too close. Fire them now!
Firing thrusters!
Captain, here's the update.
The hostages are being held in cargo bay 3. The Russians have stalled because of lack of fuel. Fedorov is going to launch one of his satellites in an hour. We have to know where.
How best can you prep Atlantis?
Half hour, tops.
Good. We're going home. Let's go.
Listen, if I could get into Fedorov's computer, I might be able to break down the codes and disable them.
Come, Roth. You're in charge. Make sure everything's ready. Do it quietly. Let's go.
Doing everything they can, Fedorov.
It's not enough.
It's just a matter of fuel. We're airlifting them a supply now. Just give us 3 more hours.
May God forgive me.
He got the feed.
He's gonna launch.
Get every fighter we've got up into the air, load them all up with heat-seeking missiles, and do it now. Can you track that thing?
I don't know. He's got 79 of them up there.
What about all those people?
We have to let them know that we are serious. If we don't think of our people, think of the thousands who have died. We can stop this right here, right now.
Remember, all the way or nothing.
What city?
No cities. We launch on Death Valley. Program. I do not want to kill anyone. I just want to let them know that we can and that we will. Now do it. It is done.
Yes, sir, Mr. President. Our planes are up. Thank you, sir. Hold on.
Have we found it yet?
It'll take time, General.
We don't have time, Pritch.
It's not headed for a city. It's coming down on Death Valley.
Are you sure?
I'm positive.
It's Death Valley. Scramble the birds at El Toro.
I've got it. It's coming across the Pacific. She hit in 31 minutes.
Great work, JJ. We got on radar now. Hang tight. We'll let you know what happens.
Someone ought to keep their eye on Fedorov. I'll do it. You sure?
Of course I'm sure. I can't let you do all the work. They may crown you a hero when this thing blows off.
Yeah, we wouldn't want that, would we?
Not if I can help it.
How can I help?
Here, hold this.
So how's that chip on my shoulder? Still there?
I'm sorry. You know, it wasn't my place to make a judgment like that.
No, you were right. It was there.
You know, this is none of my business, but what happened in that accident? Why didn't you tell NASA that?
They didn't need to know.
Colgrove thought they did.
Colgrove was wrong.
What are you so afraid of?
Not much anymore. You know what fear is? Fear is flying a T-38 with both your engines on fire. And knowing that any minute your jet might blow, there's nothing you can do about it. There's no way to put those fires out. So you look for a safe place to ditch before you bail out. Knowing that any second might be your last. That's fear.
I have visual on the bogey. Request permission to fire.
Permission granted, Bravo. Fire when ready.
Affirmative. Waiting for lock. Missiles armed. I have a lock. Box 2. NORAD, we have a hit. Target destroyed.
Down, 78 more to go. Contact Hendrix, tell him we got it.
Suki.
General, I'm sure by now your Death Valley has truly become the Valley of Death. I will give the Russians one more hour to withdraw their tanks, then I'm gonna launch 8 more satellites.
I found it in one of the airlocks.
Someone's coming aboard the station, Previ.
The hostages are gone.
Impossible. Who? Hendrix. He's going for the shuttle. Give me your gun. He's mine.
Get the hat!
Atlantis, this is Captain Hendrix.
Fedorov is on his way to the shuttle bay. Komarov, listen to me. I want you out of there now.
Don't stop for anything. Don't come back. That's an order.
Roger, Captain. Separating from docking bay. Good luck.
Short. He's gonna launch the rest of them now.
Can you disable the codes?
Not from here. Nevsky's got the computer sealed off tight.
What about shutting it down?
Shut down what?
The mainframe. If that's what Fedorov's using to launch these things, it stems to reason.
It stems to reason. If we shut down the mainframe, we shut down our life support. We are not leaving here anytime soon, JJ. If we rip out the mainframe, that's gonna kill us.
How do we do it?
JJ, please, just think about this for a minute, will you?
He's right. The station can only maintain hypostasis for a half an hour. After that, we die.
You have a little boy at home, don't you?
Ivan, they're shutting down the main power.
Switch your computer to emergency backup.
I'm working on it. Don, it's on emergency power now.
Set them to launch.
We can and we will. All or nothing. We agreed, all or nothing. Set them to launch in 15 minutes. Does the intercom still work?
It should.
You've killed us all, Hendrix. I'll hand you that.
But you have not saved the world.
When I die, millions will die with me.
If you could get to his computer, could you disable the countdown?
I think so. I came close once before.
George, you go with her.
What about you?
I'm gonna do a little of the old carrot on the stick trick. I'll lure Fedorov away from his computer. While he's gone, you two shut it down.
And that's our plan.
That's it.
Warning, all systems shutting down. Emergency power activated. Life support integrity will fail.
Gretch, you're still there.
Right here, boss.
Switch me over to Fedorov's channel and follow my lead.
He'll know you're there.
Yeah, no kidding, Bridge. Just do it.
Okay. Switching over in 10, 9, 8. I hope you know what you're doing, JJ.
Captain Hendrix, this is Houston. Come in, Captain.
Houston, this is Hendrix. How do I find the power generator and turn this thing back on?
It's in the southwest corner.
Are you sure I'll be able to access it without Fedorov knowing?
Wait for him. As soon as he steps outside, kill him. Turn on the intercom. Hendrix!
Give yourself up. It's not your fight.
It is now.
You can't stop it.
Even if you kill me, they would still launch. Think of the consequences.
Why don't you think about the consequences? It's your party.
Give up, Hendrix. You can't win.
It's not about winning or losing, Revy.
That's how you play the game.
I hope you have good lungs, Hendrix. It's about to become very difficult to breathe.
Beginning compression procedure. Warning, all systems shutting down. Emergency power activated. Life support integrity will fail in 10 minutes.
Not matter. If I'm dead, you cannot stop the launch.
Shutting down. Emergency power activated. Life support integrity will fail in 5 minutes.
How do I stop the launch?
Oh, you can't.
Don't do this. You can't let this happen.
Oh, I'm with Fedorov.
No, I don't believe you. Look at me. Look at me. Millions of people are gonna die. I have a son. Please, what about your family? your children. Come on.
They could.
What?
To disable.
What is it? What is it? Come on. Five.
Tell me how to disarm the system.
Shoot me, Hendrix. I dare you.
Houston, Houston, this is McCord.
Come in, Houston.
This is Houston.
I've got the disabled code. I'm putting it in now.
You should have given up, Hendrix.
Maybe next time.
Artificial gravity disengaged. Artificial gravity engaged. Six, five, four, three, two, one. I've disarmed the satellite.
Yeah, all right.
The satellites are disarmed.
You heard it, Fedorov. It's over.
Not yet. All I have to do is change the codes.
Fedorov launch.
Not unless he changes the frequency.
Amanda, where's Hendrix?
Don't know. I'll look, sir. JJ.
It's over.
You all right?
Okay.
Where's Teri?
Warning. All systems shutting down. Emergency power activated. Life support.
Now what?
Now we're going home. Come on. At least a dozen. In a sim.
Safely?
I came close once.
Close?
Real close. All right, Pritch. Coming in on re-entry. 16 degrees deflection.
So far, so good.
Take it around. You're looking great, JJ.
Getting hot, Pritch. 1900 degrees and climbing.
It's only gonna get hotter.
2,000, Pritch. It's getting too hot. 2,100 degrees and climbing, Pritch.
Hold steady, JJ.
2,200, Pritch. I'm gonna have to pull up.
You can make it. Trust me. Fly through it. Take the heat.
JJ!
Do it, JJ. We both know you can.
One more minute.
I'm sure he can.
Why not?
catastrophic system failure.
Hi, Jim. Oh.